Welcome to the Google Classroom of Sri Gokulam Guruvayur. Today, we are going to the next topic, crops in India. We have studied about cropping pattern in India. Rabi, Garif and Zaid. A particular crop can be grown during a particular season. The major crops in India are rice, wheat, millet, maize, pulses, sugarcane, tea, etc. Like this, we have variety of crops. Further, we can classify the crops into food crops other than grains, non-food crops, etc. So, let us study about these categories in detail. Diversity of food crops of India should be ascertained according to the factors of temperature, rainfall, and soil. Paddy, wheat and maize are the major food crops of India. So we are moving to the first food crop, that is paddy or rice. Rice. It is a staple food crops of the majority of the people in India. After China, India is the largest producer of rice. As we said, it is a garif crop. It requires high temperature, that is more than 25 degrees Celsius with high humidity. The rainfall should be more than 100 centimeter. If it is less, paddy cultivation is possible only by irrigation. Rice is grown in the plains of north and northeastern India, coastal areas and the delta region. The area of Punjab, Rajasthan, Haryana and West Uttar Pradesh have shown good cultivation of rice with help of canal and tube irrigation. The next important food crop is wheat. It is the second most important group in terms of production in India. It is a rabi crop. In north and northwest of India, it is the main food crop. It requires average rainfall of 50 to 75 cm and requires a cool growing season and bright sunshine at the time of ripening. Wheat also produced in northern states as well as southern states. There are two important wheat growing zones in the country. They are Ganga Satluj Plain in northwest and black soil region of the Deccan. The major wheat producing states are Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan and part of Madhya Pradesh. The next crop is millets. Jowar, Bajra and Ragi are the important millets. They are also known as coarse grain because they have high nutritional value like iron, calcium, micronutrients, etc. It is a rainfed crop. So, major states. Major jowar producing states are Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. And major Bajra producing states are Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Haryana. And Ragi in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Jharkhand and Arunachal Pradesh. The next crop is maize. It is the only crop which used as a food crop and fodder crop in India. It is a garif crop. It requires temperature between 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. It is also a rainfed crop. That means it depends on the rain. The major states are Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Madhya Pradesh. Then next one, pulses. India is the largest producer as well as the consumer of pulses in the world. The major pulses that are grown in India are the oud, tar, moong, maswa, peas, etc. It is restored. They are very helpful in restoring the fertility of the soil. That's why it is also known as leguminous crops. Then they need less moisture. Then the major states are Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and Karnataka. So these are the major food crops in India. The next category, food crops other than grain. Food crops other than grains. When we talk about the food crops, food means in North India we get chapati and all, and in South India we get rice. Other than this food crops, we have the non-grains, which means vegetables, fruit, sugarcane, tea, etc. So, major food crops other than grains in India are sugarcane, oilseed, tea, coffee, horticulture, crops, etc. So, we are moving to the first one, sugarcane. Sugarcane. It requires hot and humid climate with temperature of 21 degree Celsius to 27 degree Celsius. It needs annual rainfall between 75 cm and 100 cm. Irrigation is required in the low rainfall region. It needs manual labor from sowing to harvesting because the sugarcane crops grow very tall. So more people are required for the or specialized work. Then the major states are Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Bihar, Punjab and Haryana. India is the second producer of sugarcane. So who is the first producer? That is Brazil. Then sugarcane is the main source of sugar, gur, gandhasari, etc. Then the next crop is oil seeds. These are the oil seeds produced in India. Oil seed. In India, cooking doesn't happen without oil. In India, we have seeds of oil like groundnut, sunflower, palm, coconut, mustard, soya bean, castor seeds, cotton seeds and linseeds. Groundnut production is very high in India. It is a garrick crop. Gujarat is the largest producer of groundnut and it is produced in Rajasthan and Tamil Nadu also. Then the next one, tea. Tea is an important beverage crop in India. It is an example of plantation crop that we studied in previous chapter, previous topic. Then it is introduced by Britishers in India. It requires moderate temperature. Tea bushes require warm and moisture climate. Shower of rains are enough for the growth of tender leaf. It is a labor intensive industry. So the major states are Assam, Darjeeling, Jalpaiguri districts and West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala. India is the second largest producer of tea after China. Then next one, coffee. It has been a typical production in entire world. There is a special significance for the coffee seeds produced in Yemen, Arab states. But recently they brought into the India. Average, it needs the average rainfall of 150 to 200 centimeters per annum. Then, and also required moderate temperature. Initially, its cultivation was introduced on the Baba Budan Hills. Today, their major coffee producing states are Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Then moving to other crops, that is horticulture crops, that is fruits and vegetables. It includes production of vegetable and fruit. India is the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world after China. In India, it is the producer of fruit like mangoes of Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal, oranges of Nagpur and Chirapunji, banana of Kerala, Mizoram, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu, lychee and guava of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, pineapple of Meghalaya, grapes of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Maharashtra, apple, pear and apricot, walnuts are grown in Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh are great demand all over the world. It has great demand all over the world. So, these are the food crops other than grains. Then, next category is not food crops. First one, rubber. The major non-food crops that grown in India are rubber. We all know that from the stem of rubber, we can collect the milk and preserve it for long day and convert it into rubber. So, it requires moist and humid climate with rainfall of more than 200 cm and temperature above 25 degrees Celsius. It mainly grown in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Andaman and Nicobar Island and also in Garo Hills of Meghalaya. Rubber is an important industrial raw material. The next non-food crop is fiber crops. The major fiber crops grown in India are cotton, jute, hemp. These are derived from plants. And also natural silk. It obtained from cocoons of silkworms. The rearing of silkworms for the production of silk fiber is known as sericulture. What is sericulture? Rearing of silkworms for the production of silk is known as sericulture. The first one is cotton. The first fiber crop is cotton. India is the original home of cotton plants. It is the important raw material for cotton textile industry. India is the largest producer of cotton in the world. As we discussed in the first chapter, cotton grows in black soil. It requires high temperature, light rainfall and 210 frost-free days and bright sunshine. It is a garrif crop. It requires 6 to 8 months to mature. Major crop producing states are Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. The next fiber crop is jute. It is also known as golden fiber. It requires high temperature and the major states are West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Odisha and Meghalaya. It is used in the making of bag, mats, rope, carpets, etc. So, these are the major crops grown in India. So, it has high economical value or market value all over the world.
Now you understood about various crops in India. What are they?
Rice, wheat, sugarcane, pulses, tea, cotton, jute, etc. And also studied about climatic conditions that they require for the growth of these crops. And also studied about economic and or market value of these crops. You got a thorough knowledge about this topic by watching URL. You must attend the test paper sincerely and download and study the notes. So I am winding up here. See you in the next class. Children, bye.